ladies and gentlemen, the class of 2022. And now I'd like to please ask you to stand for the national anthem sung by the Aspen High School Choirs. Please be seated.
Good morning, and welcome to the Aspen High School graduation for the class of 2022. On behalf of the Board of Education, the administration, and the entire faculty of the Aspen School District, I want to welcome you to join us in the celebration for these young people. This graduation is perhaps very different from any that have gone before it. This class is also very different from any that have gone before. They have survived a pandemic, continued to learn and thrive, and for this, we are very, very thankful. This class represents a resiliency of which it can be proud, and this class represents a community's resiliency, and for that, this community can be proud. This is an exciting day, and from the bottom of my heart, I say welcome. It is my great honor to introduce someone who needs almost no introduction, the principal of Aspen High School, Mrs. Sarah Strasburger.
Students, faculty, and distinguished guests, it's my privilege to be here with you at the 133rd commencement ceremony of Aspen High School. What a treat to be back at the Benedict Music Tent. It is now my pleasure to introduce our stage guests. Audience, will you please hold your applause until all the guests have been introduced? To our guests, please stand when your name is called. Katie Frisch, the president of the Aspen School Board. Jonathan Nickel, vice president of the Aspen School Board. Dr. Susan Zimmett, assistant secretary and assistant treasurer. Stacy Weiss, treasurer. Dr. David Baugh, our superintendent. Mr. Theron Mulberry, the assistant superintendent. Ms. Becky Oliver, our assistant principal. Josh Barrow, our counselor. Karen Hawks, our post-secondary counselor. Charlie Lobby, our post-secondary counselor. And Lauren Reese, our counselor. And Chris Kelleher, our commencement speaker. Thank you for being here today. There is another group of exceptional individuals I would like to recognize. Their hard work, flexibility, and dedication to academic excellence have supported the accomplishments of our graduates here today. Will the faculty and staff of Aspen High School please stand and be recognized? And now I would like to have a special recognition for our retirees who are in attendance today. Please stand and be recognized. From Aspen Middle School, Chris Kelleher, 23 years teaching English and 31 years coaching. And from Aspen High School, our very own Mr. Chris Bonadies, 23 years of teaching. We thank you both for giving so much to our students over the course of your careers. We will miss you, and we wish you well. Now I would like to welcome Emma Boucher to the stage to perform New Year's Day.
There's glitter on the floor after the party. Girls are hanging their shoes down in the lobby. Candlelights and Polaroids on the hardwood floor. You and me from the night before. Don't breathe the last page, but I'll stay. When it's hard, it's wrong, and we're making mistakes. Midnight, but I'll be cleaning up bottles with you on New Year's Day.
Hello and good morning. My name is Reese Leonard, and I was this year's senior class president. Mother Teresa once said, "Kind words can be short and easy to speak, but their echoes are truly endless." Words can have various impactful meanings throughout our lives. Sometimes, a few simple words of wisdom from people around us can motivate us to excel in every part of our life we choose to pursue. Today's keynote speaker is going to share a few personal words that were told to him by his senior year cross-country coach at Aspen High School. These words have positively shaped every stage of his life. I am honored today to introduce a person who has impacted all of our lives in different ways throughout his last 30 plus years in the Aspen School District. Some may know him as a dedicated cross-country coach, an adventurous eighth grade outdoor ed leader, or even an encouraging literature teacher. He strives to look for every opportunity of growth in everything he does, and I think we all have something very important to learn from him. Please welcome Chris Kelleher, class of 1986.
Thanks, Reese. I always thought it'd be kind of cool to start out. Anybody who did eighth grade outdoor ed, stand up. Okay, now how about anybody who graduated from Aspen High School? So it's funny how things come together. Back in college, I was given an assignment. I probably wrote it the night before it was due, but it was to generate a list of 50 things that I wanted to do before I died. And number 43, done and done. Now I just need to see every episode of The Simpsons in order and become captain in the Starship Enterprise. I always wanted to be an astronaut. It's an honor day to stand before you. Also, one thing in 23 years of teaching I learned, I'm a little nervous because the most important thing is never turn your back on them. But it's an honor to be here. In front of the gathered guests, the dignitaries, family, friends, anyone who heard the music and thought there might be food. And I'm humbled by this opportunity to share some words with you as you take the next steps forward into the future. Sir Ospos told me to keep this between 7 to 9 minutes, so I'll try to hurry things up. And before I really begin, I'm Irish. So there's a real chance that I could just burst out into tears at any moment. I could also get into a fist fight. So as long as no one bursts into Danny Boy or the fields of Athenry, I think we're good. And what I have to say to you all is pretty important. I remember every word that was spoken at my own graduation way back in 1986, except for what was actually said. I don't even remember who spoke. So I called my friend. It was a ski racer named Jimmy Huga, but I don't remember what he said. So I'm going to try to do better for you all. I wasn't sure what I should speak about. My dad actually spoke here in 1984. So I thought, hey, why not pirate his speech? But then there's that whole Turnitin.com thing, right? So that was out. And I asked my kids, what do you think I should talk about? And they said, it doesn't really matter because they're just going to be looking at the kids in the funny hats. So, I turn to your soon-to-be former administrators, teachers. The Sciency Group, Mark Whitley asked me to mention his name, but the Sciency Group I'm not really sure what they were talking about, but I got like quantum something or other and thermo-technical sounding thing. I have no idea. The English department was barricaded in their rooms behind the final papers and projects. World languages, spoken tongues. But I did get son las cinco en algún lugar. It's 5 o'clock somewhere. And the history department didn't seem like they wanted their heated alpaca versus llama debate interrupted. So I went to the higher-ups. Strasbos and Becky were clearly administratoring, which is a word. So I didn't want to bug them. Went up to Dr. Baugh's office. I got solar panels! And all I got from Theron was 2022, 2022. So then I said, well, hey, what about the counselors? They kind of know what they're talking about. So I went and I knocked on Josh's door, but time stand still was cranked so loud he didn't hear me knocking. So I figured I was on my own. And now I'm down to about 4 minutes, so I'll keep it simple. If you remember nothing else from today, carry this with you. Look at your classmates, the audience, your teachers, the custodial staff, the bus drivers, the coaches, look at your family, look at your friends, and those who heard the music and thought there might be food. That's your village. And they've spent the vast majority of the past 18 years urging you to be better. Think about all those who've had your back at all times, in all situations. What they've been doing all this time is helping you to be better. So Aspen was founded on this idea of the Aspen idea, blending mind, body, and spirit, is rooted in the idea of be better. Those of us who grew up here grew up with this, subliminally, however, as a backdrop to everything we did, academics, athletics, service to others. So in addition to teaching eighth grade, this is what Reese is referring to, for the past 23 years, I've also coached since 1991, the boys and the girls cross country team. And in athletics, it's easy to find a place to be better. When I was in high school, Mark Whitley can attest to this, way back when dirt was clean and right after the last glaciers had melted, my high school cross country coach, George Burson, introduced me not so subtly to the idea of be better. One day in one of our workouts, one of my teammates asked if we could only do 5 of the 10 800 meter repeats. His explosion of invective ended with him thundering, "Hell no, you can't do 5. Don't negotiate for mediocrity." We did all 10. Be better, right? And again, in athletics, I worked as a photographer years ago, and I had the opportunity to meet Andre Agassi on a few occasions. He was often late to the shoots he would do because he didn't want to miss his workouts. He said, "I can't miss any workouts. Being number 2 sucks." Now, being number 1 is awesome, but very few of us will ever get the chance to be number 1 at anything. You don't have to be number 1, just be better. And many times, striving to be better gets you to number 1. Ask the swim team, the golf team, the dance squad, the basketball team. Ask this year's valedictorian. Years ago, when citizens were asked to do something not for themselves, but for the good of the country, when we as a nation were tasked with going to the moon and returning safely, and when the country was asked not to judge people by the color of their skin, but by the content of their character, all that was a way of challenging us to be better. Okay, remember the village I pointed out before? Subtly, perhaps explicitly, your villagers have urged you to be better. And you've already started to put it into practice. Among you sit people who will go on to make the world better as professionals in one field or another. Perhaps as swimmers, skiers, basket, volleyball, football players, lacrossers, golfers. I don't know if lacrossers is a word, but it is now. Electricians, architects, accountants, musicians, filmmakers, anglers. Someone in here caught a 700-pound tuna. That's amazing. Some of you may even find work creatively removing the boot from your car. There's probably good money in that. And a special shout out to those of you who are going to go on to selflessly serve the country as members of the armed forces. Whatever your direction and drive, I hope your greatest value comes not from the size of your paycheck, but from the satisfaction of fighting the good fight and giving back to the community. Just be better. Now, as a running coach, no self-respecting running coach can let a chance to let a quote from Pre escape. So here's mine. Steve Prefontaine at one time held every American track record from 2,000 to 10,000 meters. Pre let the world know that to give anything less than your best is to sacrifice the gift. Pre was speaking about running, but his message is transcendent. It's just a lot of syllables that really say, be better. I'm not sure, I'd have to check with the English department, but I don't think Pre and William Faulkner ever met. And Faulkner, in one of his shortest sentences on records, wrote, don't bother just to be better than your contemporaries or predecessors. Try to be better than yourself. So, graduates, not just graduates, but parents, teachers, administrators, counselors, board members, those of you who heard the music and thought there might be food, listen up. You have it within you, each of you, to be better with everything you do. Be passionate about what you do. Whatever you do, do it with conviction. Don't negotiate for mediocrity. You don't have to be number one. You don't have to be perfect. Just be better. Though if one of you becomes an astronaut, do whatever you can to get me a seat. Window or aisle. That would be perfect. Okay, so thank you for this opportunity to share with you today what we, your village, look forward to marvel, and just know that we look forward to marveling at the mark you will leave on the world. Whatever you do, don't sacrifice your gift. Be better in mind, body, and spirit. Just be better. Thank you. And now I'd like to welcome to the stage the Aspen Choirs, who will perform Crowded Table by the Highway Women.
Hold on, when you need to let go. At this time, I would like for Layla Khan Faruqi and her parents to join me here at the podium. Layla represents the graduating class of 2022 as the salutatorian of Aspen High School. Layla is a national merit semifinalist, a recipient of the prestigious Pace Setter Mathematics Award, and she is one of our Aspen scholars. Layla is an expert math teacher. She enjoys coaching other students, and they appreciate her way of explaining complicated topics. She has inspired both middle and high school students to strive for excellence in the world of mathematics. Layla's stellar senior year was also highlighted by a unique opportunity to shadow multiple physicians at the Stedman Clinic. She will be attending Duke University, where she will study computational biology and bioinformatics. Ladies and gentlemen, please show your appreciation for Aspen's 2022 salutatorian, Layla Khan Faruqi.
Thank you. Good morning, esteemed guests, teachers, administrators, family, friends, students, and of course, the Aspen High School class of 2022. I would like to welcome you all to our graduation. I am honored to represent my classmates as this year's salutatorian. First off, I would like to thank each and every one of you for the constant support that you have given us throughout these past 4 years. Teachers, without all of your flexibility during online learning and forgiving grading policies in this somewhat post-COVID world, I can confidently say that not a single one of us would be sitting here today. Honestly, I can't believe we didn't take this as our third ditch day. Parents, thank you for keeping us on top of our studies. You were the ones who sat dutifully by our sides at the dining room table, yelling at us because we just couldn't figure out how to find the limit of the given function. Megan, Schraub, I'm going to be honest, I'm still not really sure how you're supposed to take a limit, but it seems like a problem for August. Siblings, thank you for your contributions to the success of the class of 2022. Some of us, like myself, are fortunate enough to be the oldest, and we get to set the bar as low or as high as we want. Mino, you can probably step over the one I'll be leaving for you. Others, however, have had to strive constantly over these past 4 years to live up to the expectations left behind by their older siblings. You push them to be the best versions of themselves. Still others, who have no siblings, probably just got to spend a lot of extra time crying at the dining room table with their math homework. But in all seriousness, thank you to everyone who has encouraged and assisted us during our high school years. Each person here played an essential role in the growth and development of every member of the class of 2022. And your support has led us to where we are today, waiting anxiously to walk across the stage and receive our diplomas in order to begin the next era of our lives. Let's give you all a hand. Now, in the words of esteemed race car driver Ricky Bobby's father, if you aim first, you're last. As your salutatorian, this means I'm speaking to you today as first loser in the race for highest GPA. Don't get me wrong, I feel exceedingly honored and fortunate to be granted this opportunity. Rather, I would like to draw your attention to the idea of losing. I'm sure we've all heard some version of the cliche about true winners embracing failure, but in the context of this statement, losing, you know, not winning, is equated with failure. Personally, I don't know how much I agree with that idea that winning, that not winning is the same as failing. Of course, I'm just a 17-year-old girl about to graduate high school, and to be honest, I've never really won anything, so what do I even know? Today, sitting behind me on the stage are state champions in dance, basketball, and golf. Our class boasts athletes of the year in multiple sports, and we have students going to some of the top universities in the nation. Aspen High School is full of winners. However, not all of us have been able to bask in the glory of first place. For example, my swim team took second place at state during my sophomore year. I will say I am very good at being first loser. But this was in no way a failure. We lost to a team with six times the number of competitors we had, and each person on our five-woman team swam personal bests in their individual events. I remember all of us being ecstatic, screaming, jumping, yelling. It brought us closer as a team and set the tone for future seasons. In all of our minds, it was the culmination of our hard work and long hours in the pool. So how could this possibly be classified as a failure? A loss, maybe. A failure, not in the slightest. To me, failure is not the same thing as our ski team securing runner-up at state this year. It's not the same thing as my Calc 3 classmates and I scoring between a 0 and a 35% on our integration unit test. Actually, maybe it is. But it isn't the same as our class continuously losing to the sophomores in practically every pep rally game. That might have been embarrassing, but it wasn't a failure because we did get markedly better as the year went on. And anyway, I'm pretty sure the sophomores were cheating. Failure, by its dictionary definition, is simply a lack of success. Very few, if any, of the endeavors, achievements, wins, and losses of the class of 2022 represent a lack of success. In most cases, our losses are actually demonstrations of personal growth that have allowed us to cultivate current and future winners. Even so, test scores, placements in competition, and general outcomes are not our destination. They're merely steps along our path of life. Our success lies in the journey and the decisions we make along the way. Duke University's Coach K once said, "One has to be positive about all things that happen to his team. Look at nothing in the past as failure." I believe that this quote embodies the Aspen High School outlook on loss versus failure. We are winners who embrace loss, but do not claim that it is our failing. However, there may be one way for us to fail, and it exists when we refuse to fight for our tomorrow. We are the future, and we should back our actions with the intention to better our world. When we leave here today, we are closing the book on our past 4 years at Aspen High School and stepping into our roles in the workforce, the military, and at university. I would like to emphasize to every single student sitting behind me and in the audience that your 4 years of high school are not the best years of your life. In fact, they shouldn't be. High school is a chance to learn and grow and begin to discover who you want to be. It's filled with mistakes, friends, fights, lessons, and entirely too much homework for a semester of senior year. All of us have our entire lives to look forward to, and I believe that we should not restrict ourselves to how enjoyable or not the past 4 years were. We must look towards tomorrow and the way in which our successes as Aspen High School students will shape the future. I have no doubt that all of us will make a positive impact wherever we end up, and we will continue to take our wins and losses with equal humility and grace. Together, we will build a better tomorrow because of all that we've learned as the class of 2022. The final thought that I would like to leave with all of you comes from Kurt Vonnegut. True terror is to wake up one morning and discover that your high school class is running the country. Congratulations, graduates. And to everyone else, please join us in celebrating the beginning of the rest of our lives. I think I speak for everyone when I say I'm excited and slightly nervous to see what we become. Thank you. Go skiers.
great job. Hard act to follow. Good morning. At this time, I would like for Gemma Hill and her parents to join me here at the podium. Gemma represents the graduating class of 2022 as the valedictorian of Aspen High School. Gemma is one of our Aspen scholars, a recipient of the prestigious Principals Award and the Pacesetter Science Award, as well as several other awards that testify to her achievements as a scholar, athlete, and community member. Gemma played a pivotal role in the school's leadership team. She met with the team once a week to offer students perspective. She challenged our thinking, made us laugh, and helped us make informed decisions that will improve Aspen High School for years to come. Gemma will be attending UCLA, where she will study neuroscience. Ladies and gentlemen, please show your appreciation for Aspen's 2022 valedictorian, Gemma Hill.
Hi, I'm Gemma, obviously. From the class of 2022, hello and welcome! I understand that you may be wondering about my sartorial choices today. Well, out of the 36 months of high school, we spent 10 months on Zoom in our onesies. So today, I am choosing to pay homage to those comfortable yet profoundly impactful years. I'd like to begin by apologizing for the tedious and rather cliche amount of thank yous that you are all about to be bombarded with, but here we go anyway. On behalf of the class of 22, I'd like to thank the teachers. And I would say a round of applause for every time you told us to pull up our masks, but I think we all know there's not enough time in this ceremony for that, no matter how long the ceremony is. A huge thank you to administration and the custodial staff for always being there to clean up our messes. The juniors are working on doing better. Thank you to all the parents sitting in the audience. You have supported us and allowed us to grow and thrive. And thank you to our SROs for always keeping us safe. And now the real kahuna. Let's all get rowdy for Zoom and showing off each of our childhood dwellings in all their glory. Seriously, though, speaking of COVID, I think it's customary that we all give each other a round of applause. I mean, desks 6 feet apart, a closed town, online school, a raging Candy Crush addiction, and Sarah Benson yelling at us for boxing during bio. It was certainly not without its blunders, but here we are. So to the class of 22 and the town of Aspen, congratulations, because today we have the pleasure of enduring the normalcy of an indoor graduation ceremony, and that in itself is an accomplishment. And to my family, the rather large clan sitting right over there, you are my role models and my inspiration. To my parents specifically, thank you for allowing me to grow up in a household filled with food, music, love, and laughter. I wouldn't be here without you, and I do mean that quite literally. And last, but most definitely not least, shout out to the class of 22. To Gabe, whose laugh makes the world go round. To my all-time favorite Whitley. Yes, I am referring to Mark. To Tiger Campisi, who gave flowers to my mother. To Caden O'Connell, who has been my academic hero since day one. We're going on about 8 years since Country Day now. Shout out to Caden. To Stellan McAniff, whose art humbles us all. And to all the other athletes, artists, actors, musicians, academics, and culinary enthusiasts that make this class exceptional. And to, when I was given this job, a good friend of mine said to me, Gemma, whatever you do, do not put metaphors in your speech, and do not, under any circumstances, make any puns, because I can guarantee that you are the only one who finds them funny. I'd love to say I considered it his input, but I'm afraid this speech will be a bit of a punishment to Zach Small. Sorry, Zach Small. Now is an ode to all the pop quizzes we've been given. I'd like to take this opportunity to give my own. Please stand up, audience members and graduates alike, if you have ever had the pleasure of calling Aspen home. Quite a few of you. Now take this opportunity to look around, to see all the people that have interwoven their lives into yours, and take a page out of the class of 2022 and choose to proceed with empathy. Thank you, you may all be seated. Getting involved. This class has no doubt endured significant challenges over these 4 years, but rather than choose to see the world through the rather bleak depictions by the media, we chose to appreciate the small wonders, the mathematical marvel of a pine cone, Megan Noonan's math memes. Oh my God, Megan Noonan's math memes! Joey Dietzick's long list of nicknames, and of course, loungewear. This town has fostered us to grow into compassionate young adults. It has taught us the lessons of life through frostbite, close encounters with bears, and dangerous climbs. Now, this is probably the part where the orator, me, is supposed to give a small anecdotal story. But quite frankly, storytelling is not my forte. So I will save myself the embarrassment and save you all the time and simply say that growing up in this town has given us the tools necessary to take the world by storm, because I think we can all agree that it's a very specific student that exits Aspen. They're filled with grit, determination, and a healthy relationship with a wildly unrealistic amount of discomfort. For example, I've been on the high school swim team for 3 years now. I wake up every morning at 5 a.m. to coach here on 3A Swimmer of the Year. Shout out to Kayla. Meanwhile, I'm still a terrible swimmer, but it's about the grit, right? I see it every day in Jake Morgan as he charges down the race course, in Christian Marenko and Amy Amaya as they receive their bilingual diplomas, in the boys' basketball team, the golf team, and the dance team as they take home the state championship, in every student here who has taken IB Physics. That's the one. In all the seniors who have made the choice to strike up an argument with Scott Reed. That takes some perseverance. And in Lucas Lee, as he proceeds into this next chapter with an unimaginable strength of character. So while Aspen will always remain our jumping off point, the class of 22 will now spread across the world to Berlin, Hawaii, Paris, Switzerland, the UK, and all across the States, taking each of their incredible goals and dreams with them. And if you are to take anything from this speech, remember that everyone is doing extraordinary things. And so take this time to appreciate and encourage the people around you, just as the people sitting behind me have done for me. Go forward with the compassion, intrigue, curiosity, and the spirit of the class of 2022, because the world around us is big and complex and sometimes maddening and fun. And I can tell you right now that the wondrous people sitting behind me will have no trouble navigating it. Thank you all so much. Go skiers, but more importantly, go Bruins! And now I have the pleasure of introducing our next performance by Adriana Cipinari, Elijah Goldman, Garrett Green, and Thea Hecht, singing Wide Open Spaces.
Left home, who's never struck out to find a dream and a life of their own. A place in the clouds, a foundation of stone. Many proceed and many will follow. A young girl's dreams no longer hollow. It takes the shape of a place. What it holds for her, she hasn't yet guessed. She needs wide open spaces, room to make her big mistakes. She needs new faces, she knows the high stakes. She traveled this road as a child. Wide-eyed and grinning, she never tired. But now she won't be coming back with the rest. If these are life's lessons, she'll take this test. She needs wide open spaces, room to make her big mistakes. She needs new faces. She knows the high stakes. She knows the high stakes.
Ladies and gentlemen, let's give one more huge round of applause to all of our musicians and vocalists today. A I love beautiful music, and what a better place to be. Seniors, this is it. You have made it. We are here back in this gorgeous tent with beautiful live music, back to normal. The class of 2022 has not only weathered a global pandemic that left you with just two normal full years of high school, you have also managed to continue the tradition of excellence at Aspen High School. Whether you are amassing hundreds of service hours, taking myriad IB classes, working full-time outside of school, participating in robotics and FBLA, acting in productions, singing in our choirs, getting certified to teach skiing or yoga, excelling in athletics, and so much more, this class stands as an exemplar of the very best that Aspen has to offer. You are the reason that I have such hope for the future. As our nation and our world continues to be in various stages of unrest, it is your generation and your class who has the power, talent, and, dare I say it, rich opportunity to set us all on a new path, a better path. A path that mirrors what I saw every day in the halls of Aspen High School this year. Smart, compassionate, engaged, and vocal students who stand up for what they believe, treat others with decency and respect, and who are not afraid to challenge the status quo, or me. I see you helping underclassmen, cheering on your peers, solving problems in your classes, advocating for mental health, celebrating diversity, and just being good humans. I know that you can meet the challenges of this world head on. You have triumphed in the midst of this pandemic. Who better to make this world a more just and compassionate place? You, the class of 2022. As I look at all of you, I think back to the glorious day when the mask requirement was lifted. Some adults, I was probably in that team, were worried that students would judge each other or be unkind for their choices. But all that I saw was a sea of beautiful, smiling faces or smiling eyes, and students grateful for one another. You proved the grown-ups wrong. And again, I'm filled with hope. As you sit here today, I want you to look at your peers, your teachers, your friends, and family, and remember your fortitude. You are here in this beautiful tent. You are unmasked. You are triumphing. You are graduating. And much like Mr. Kelleher said, every day I know we all can be better. Go out into this world knowing that you are the change we so desperately need. Focus on everything that you have, not on what you do not. Approach others with kindness and compassion like you have in Aspen High School, for who knows what they are enduring. Look for opportunities rather than lament misfortunes. And most importantly, embrace the hope that you symbolize for me and for others. You can and will make a difference in this world. Students of the class of 2022, please know how honored I am to be standing here with you today as your principal. Your compassion, your sense of humor, your diligence, and your ability to stand up for what is right will stay with me for many years to come. You will be sorely missed, not only by me, but also by the staff and students of Aspen High School. We all look forward to hearing about all of your future successes. There are going to be so many. And as alumni, you will always be welcome in our halls. Go Skiers. Mrs. Frisch, I'd like to invite you to the podium. The seniors before us have satisfied the graduation requirements set forth by the Aspen Board of Education. On behalf of the entire staff at Aspen High School and the Aspen community, I present these seniors to you to accept this senior class of 2022 for diploma distribution.
Congratulations, everyone. As the president of the Board of Education, I hereby accept that the students before me have completed the required course of study and met the guidelines set forth by this board to graduate from Aspen High School. These diplomas will certify that these students have graduated from Aspen High School on this day, the 4th of June, 2022. Congratulations, everyone.
Emilio Adams. L. Amatula. Amy Giselle Amaya Argueta. Avalanche Abigail Batcher. Sadie Rose Baco. Ronnie Jade Juin Bedford. Leah Lauren Beller. Jacqueline Mayeli Benitez Martinez. Micah Rose Bodkins. Emma Cecile Boucher. Quinn Hux Bowden. Derek Lewis Brown. Tiger Chance Campisi. Althea Grace Carlin. Adriana Angela Cipinari. Sebastian Alfredo Cisneros. Lily Claire Citrin. Joseph Thomas Clark. Elizabeth Love Dangler. Catherine Copsey Dangler. Nadia Magdalena Debska. Marcus Johan Dwyer. Miguel Angel Diaz. Calla Grace Deemer. Eliza Lee Dominguez. Riley Shane Dunn. Linnea Brooke Earl. Ariana Marie Ilias Baumgartner. Jennifer Victoria Ellis. Madeline Renee Fellen. Chloe Bell Ferraro. Charles Wyatt Forrester. Jack Franklin Fox. Miranda Galindo Flores. Devi Amelie Gallagher. Benjamin Steven Godomsky. Elijah Rigg McDonald Goldman. Gemma Goss. Nicole Renee Goth. Garrett Frank Green. Sophia Rachel Griper. Bodie Timothy Grogan. Braden Thomas Hayesfield. Stella Grace Halferty. Isabella Grace Hanneman. Nikki Patricia Harris. Cameron James Hart. Thea Kitty Hecht. Lindsay Grace Heineken. Gemma Alexandra Hill. Ahmed Sharif Hamani. Georgia Florence Hollander. Yeah. Simon Christopher Holloway. Peter Charles Holmbeck.
Porter.
Oh my gosh. Sorry, Porter. Robert Herman Holton. Mia Blue Iacono. Joshua Dove Jacobs. Lily Marjorie Jacobson. Jack Wolfgang Jansen. Lynn Hara. Ava Alexandra Kaplan. Lauren Elizabeth Kelly. Cooper Story Kendrick. Layla Confaruki. Braden Harper Corpola. Shay Curran Corpola. Kenton Joseph Kowar. Lucas Stetson Lee. Porter Jared Lee. Reese Ella Leonard. Leon Lila. Sophia Marie Mant. Christian Ariel Marenko. Celia Shin Ja Marolt. Peter Vincent Marin. James Anthony Marrero. Lee
Lily Catherine McAllister. Alexander James McAniff. Stella Catherine McAniff. Quinn Summers McKee. Beau James Melton. Lunar Lucille Moore. Jesus Morales Molina. Jake Everett Rolf Morgan. George Lawrence Morrison. Matthew Daniel Nicholas. David Hudson Nunes. John Patrick O'Callahan. Kated Dearmid O'Connell. Declan Flynn O'Donohue. Tigis Elsa Peshek. Grace Foster Peterson. Nicholas John Pevney. Rance Wayne Pillins. River Wayne Pillins. Hannah Elizabeth Popish. Harper Sydney Rafelson. Hayden Elizabeth Reese. Brennan Harrison Reed. Gabriel Armando Rodriguez. Sergio Ruiz Zuniga. Riley Britton Rushing. Lily Lily Louise Sanders. Martin Michael Scanlon. Sydney Morgan Shaldak. John Holver Dong Shilla. Timothy Carter Schlumberger. Carter Jack Schmela. Michelle Adele Seltzer. Noelle Juliet Shield Taylor. Maya Abigail Schindel. Jacob Aaron Siegel. Lags John Simone. Ashley Elise Schlesinger Hall. Isla Ray Smagala. Zachary Richard Small. Alexander Julius Smith. Dominic Calvin Smith. Hannah Elizabeth Smith. Kiernan Van Smith. Isabella Ramos Soria. William M. Stiller. Broderick Robert Taylor. Kayla Tarani. Devin Eliza Thomas. Kara Ann Van Alstein. Brian Servando Vargas Martinez. Samuel Joseph Christopher Veazey. Nicholas Kellogg Waldeck. Anders Christian Weiss. Addison Ann Weldon. Ansel Harper Whitley. Claire Marie Wolfer Jenkins. Chloe Charlotte Ryder.
I love you. I love you.
Francesca Margaret Ituri. Laurel Jean Yule. Zane Harrison Zachary.
I'd now like to invite our co-heads of school, Lucas Lee and Lindsay Heineken, to the stage. They will be leading our students in the changing of the tassel. Ladies and gentlemen, I present to you Aspen High School's Class of 2022.